Once again, welcome students. We were discussing the story Great Man's Gift by R.K. Narayan, and this is the second lecture of this story. In the first lecture, we discussed about Govind Singh, his boss, the general manager of Englandia's, right? And the conversation that took place between these two people. Okay, the conversation took place only twice. First time when Govind Singh had joined the company as a gatekeeper, first time when the boss, means general manager, had just entered the premises and had saluted him this way, and he had asked him, "Who are you?" Okay, and then he introduced himself to him. So it was the first meeting, and this is the second time when the general manager or the boss talked to him, right? Govind Singh's wife used to work at the households of other people, washing and swimming. Okay, and she used to earn a bigger amount of money. Both of them were happy with a pension of 25 rupees and some amount which was earned by his wife. Okay, so now see, a change occurred in his life actually. It happens in the lives of most of the people, especially those people who work in the offices, right? Government or private offices, because they're just kind of servants, right? The staff members, etc. So many a time when they are in the offices, when they work somewhere until their retirement, their life is quite different. Okay, it's kind of office life. But when they get retired, the course of their life definitely changes. So sometimes tremendous changes occur in their lives. So the same happened with Govind Singh also. After retirement, what to do? So one day, what happened? He started, actually one girl came to him, and she was carrying a doll, and it had got somewhat broken, okay, from somewhere, and she requested Govind Singh to get it repaired, and he mended it, okay, repaired it. At the same time, he got an idea that he also can get engaged himself into this field, that is making different models out of clay, right? It was kind of a fascinating idea, and he started working on that. So a shop was there from where he procured dust, and another shop was there from where he procured other things necessary for making dolls, clay, and all those things. Okay, and he chose a particular part in the backyard of his house, and there he would sit and would create, you know, would make the dolls and the other models out of clay. So it became his routine. Okay, every day he would sit there, and he was happy with this kind of work also. Okay, he sat there in the front part of his home, bent over his clay, and brought into existence a miniature universe. All the colors of life were there, all the forms and creatures. So he made different models, and artistically, skillfully, he was making those models. Now see, every month he had to go to his old office to take his pension. Okay, he would go to the accountant, the office, and requesting for the pension, and this way would get the pension. So after some days, when he started this work of making dolls and other things from the clay, different models, he once carried one of the wonderfully made model with him, and he went to the office. Most of the times he would keep those models in his cousin's shop, which attracted a huge crowd, and so many people would appreciate his art, his craft, and him also for making such a beautiful, wonderful models, right? So the first time, on his next pension day, the first time when he went to his old office, he carried to his office a street scene. Okay, it was a kind of model, okay, made of clay, right? which he ranked as his best, and he had thought of that particular model as his masterpiece, and handed it over to the counter to the accountant with the request, give this to the side please. And when he went to the accountant for collecting his pension, he handed over that particular model to the accountant and requested the accountant to give it to the sahib. Here sahib means the general manager. "All right," said the accountant with a smile. It created a sensation in the office and disturbed the routine of office working for nearly half an hour. When he gave that model to the accountant and requested him to hand over the same to the general manager, the staffers, the people who were working there, okay, the staff members, everyone over there was attracted, was fascinated towards this particular skill or the craft of that model, and they had but appreciation only, okay, for Gobind Singh. It happened twice, it happened thrice, it happened many times. Okay, whenever he went there, in the beginning of every month, he would carry with him a model and would again give it to the accountant and would request him to hand over the same to the boss. Right, so the second time what happened? The second time he carried another model, children at play. Okay, he had shown so many children who were there playing in the playground. Okay, this was, and again requested to hand over the same to the sahib. After some days, it happened, it continued for so many days, so many months, and lastly, at last he made his masterpiece. It is given here that it was his masterpiece, right? A model of his office. A model of his office. The same office where he was working. Had shown in his model the people working in the office. He showed himself also as a gatekeeper, the car, and a big cabin of his boss and other people working there. Okay, all those things were made of clay, but they were so artistically made that the kind of liveliness was there. Okay, they seemed to be very live, right? Very live. So, a model of his office, front gate with himself at his post, a car at the entrance, and the chief. Chief means manager. Getting down from his car. This composite model was so realistic that while he sat looking at it, he seemed to be carried back to his office days. Okay. So, when he continuously looked at that model created by himself, he got, you know, had lost in his memories actually, right? After that, what happened? He just again handed it over to the accountant and requested him the same, that is, just give it to the son. After a week, what happened? After a week, he received a letter when he was knitting that clay, so that he would make different models. The postman came and said, "A registered letter for you." So the postman arrived at his home and told him that, "I have a letter for you." For me, it was very shocked. It was really astonished. It was literally shocked when the postman said that, "I have a letter for you." Any letter would have upset Singh. He had received less than 3 letters in his lifetime. In total, he had received only 3 letters, okay, in his entire lifetime. And each time it was kind of a catastrophe for him, it was a kind of torture for him till the contents were read out. "Now, a registered letter, only lords send registered letters, isn't it so?" is what he said, the postman. So, he was so afraid, he was so frightened that when he heard the word that registered letter, he was literally shocked because he had received only 3 letters by that particular point of time. And every time it literally, worked a kind of havoc on him in his life. And that's why he was too much frightened when he heard about that letter. What happened then? His wife had gone somewhere. She was out. And after some time, she came back. And she saw Gobind Singh. He was very frightened, he had really lost his senses, he His voice had choked and was fumbling for words, right? So this was the condition of Singh. So when he showed that he had received the letter, he showed it to his wife, and his wife just usually as usual said, just open it. But he was so frightened, and he said that if I open it, then definitely it will be a kind of problem for us, because we have already been landed many a time in problem because of these letters. Because most of the times we receive the letters from the lawyers only, okay, and it must be about some judicial related letter, okay, throwing us into the trouble. So this way he was frightened, he was afraid, and that's why he did not open the letter, he did not read the content of the letter. So what happened next, we'll be discussing it in the next video lecture. Thank you, we stop here.